Archers, welcome to Arcit. Here we like to demystify creative expressions and help in spreading awareness. And today in this video, I would like to talk about a very important part, which is curves. Now if we see, there are many different types of curves, and in architecture, we have to explore organic geometries if we are interested in that domain. We can play with curves to make different kind of forms. And I think in general mathematics also, these equations are very helpful to generate geometry, and geometry is a very integral part in mathematics as well. So I think for students or for general public should be aware about different equations and different curves, such that they can use these organic geometries and these beautiful expressions in their lives. So list of famous curves: conchoid, cycloid, ellipse, frequency curve, serpentine curve, catenary curves. If I talk about Sagittarius Familia, this is a very good example to discuss the beautiful nature of how we can use curves in architecture. In this case, a rope was suspended, it was hanging by itself, and the shape it took under gravity, that was considered as the geometry of the form or the form of this cathedral. So Antonio Gaudi really used this kind of geometry to create something really amazing. And I think in architecture, we can really explore these geometries and mathematical expressions and create a very interesting project. This can be our concept or form development. So very helpful process. So let's jump into an equation and explore it a little bit. So this is my Rhino environment. I've just made a simple NURBS curve in my Rhino environment. And I'll try to make a wavy form using this curve and then play with it. It can be an offset of this curve, then make a form. Or what I'll better do is create a wave in the Z direction so that I can get an interesting form, interesting wave, and then extrude it for the geometry. So I'll start by opening my Grasshopper environment. I'll organize my windows for better view angle. Yes, view mode, canvas, okay, everything is good. So as you can see, this is a planar curve in x and y plane. So it will be better if I'll extrude it in the z direction. I can better start by adding a curve. Select this curve and then internalize the data. Sometimes what happens, you delete the curve, you shouldn't lose your progress over it. So it is always better to internalize the data before changing anything severe in the project. So this is that curve which I wanted to start with. So there is a very interesting tool in Grasshopper named Graph Mapper. What it does is having a different types of graphs in it. I'll just move it upwards for better quality. See, as you can see, there is Bezier graph, Gaussian. I'll just make and show it. This is a Bezier graph, Bezier curve. There are different types of graphs in it. There is sine graph, which I'll probably use for this demonstration. Then there is Perlin noise, Perlin graph, which can be used, and parabola, anything can be done. So for this video, I'll stick with the sine curve. This is my curve, and I like to start by getting points from this curve through which I can play or manipulate using. So I'll divide this curve into points. So the command for is a divide curve. You can also find it in curve, in division, you'll get this divide curve. So you can select your curve. As you can see, by default, this curve has been divided into 10 points. You have to always read your data. Here it is also written that one locally defined value 10. So this curve has these 10 points. What I'll do is get a range of 40 to 150 points, because I think that will help me understand See, as soon as I have implemented a value, you can see there are 40 points now. I can increase the number of points. So I'll start with 10 instead for the better visual quality. So these are 10 points and this is the curve. So my goal is to move it in the Z direction. So I'll do the move command. My geometry is this set of points. As you can see, the distance is not very significant. My motion has to be in the Z direction. So I'll go with unit Z, get it in the Z direction, which by default as well, it was going that direction, as you can see. So now I have to choose a factor. Now this factor will define the distance I'm trying to move my points. So if I'll select 30 might be a lot. If I'll select, I'll just choose a bar for this. If I select 10, in this panel I've started with a value of 10. I don't think that is a lot. So I'll switch it up to 300, I think. That might be, yeah, 300 is looking fine. So I'll go with a factor of 300. Now, as for the demonstration, my objective is to move these points with respect to this kind of curve as shown in this graph. So I'll select my parameters, what I want to generate. So I have to give this parameter to this factor so that these points can move as per the requirement of this wave. For that, I think the best operation can be multiplication, which is a simple algebraic multiplication, doing some results like this. I think the geometry is very staggered and very edgy currently. If I'll just make curve polyline through points, not this one, polyline through points, and choose these vertices, this curve is coming out to be very jagged. I have to smoothen this curve. I think the problem is coming out because there is not sufficient distance between these points in this wave. So I can do it by increasing this X span, and that will simplify, and also increasing the number of vertices that will help me identify the problem. Okay. Yeah, I think this is much better. So as you can see how I have created a sine, beautiful sine curve. So I can create this kind of geometry. I think I can demonstrate very easily how different curves can be explored. I'll just switch this graph to a Perlin graph. Then you can see how this curve has been converted. I hope this is visually fine, explanatory. Or I can also switch this graph to conic graph. So I'll stick with sine. It is a continuous curve, like a, as you can see, this is a parabolic curve. So I'll, for this tutorial, I'll stick with sine. And this is a beautiful sine curve which I have explored. Now this is the polyline, so I'll just hide this, disable the preview so that you can see the simple geometry. I also hide this part, this curve. So this is the sine curve which is coming out. Now there are many strategies which I can go through, like for example, this was my initial curve. I can offset this curve. I can offset this curve at a distance of, I think 10 would be good, or more than 10. I think I'll use a panel again for it, 1000. Just make it proportionately fine. For example, 450, I think this will be good. So this is looking a little bit better. Now this is my second curve. What I can do is go through the same process, like divide this curve and stuff like this. So I'll just select my code over here, just copy it once more and input my curve. So this has generated the same kind of geometry on this curve. Again, I'll hide this entire information. Now I have these two beautiful curves which are running parallelly to each other. These are the two curves. So what I can do is, one is I can sweep. So before sweeping, I think I need a rail as well. So I'll just connect the extents of these curves. So endpoints, curve one has two endpoints, and similarly this was my initial curve, this was the offset curve. So if I'll just select both of them, points, if I'll select the start point, it is selecting both the start points. Now I can make a polyline through curves, which is the same tool. So I'll choose these two vertices. Is this creating a point? No, it is not. So instead, I'll deselect it. I'll again use the same endpoints code. Input this curve, use this start point, or choose the start points of both into this vertices. That will be much better. I don't think this will work. This is the start point, this is the start point. So point, it's not working. So I'll make a line which is simple start and end point. So I'm providing two point and it is creating this line. Now this will give me the rail which has to be sweeping throughout these two curves. So I have three important things. This is the line. I'll just hide these as well. Now I have the three important things. Curve A, which is the sine A curve, sine B, and this is the rail. Now I can simply sweep using sweep to command. Now it is asking for first rail, which is this one. It is asking for second rail, which is this one. And this will be my cross section, which has to flow throughout these curves. So as you can see, it is creating a very interesting kind of geometry, which is a free flowing form throughout those sections. And it is also creating an interesting pattern, which can be explored. Now there are many things which we can use for this, for equal divisions, for example, of these points, for distancing it equally so that the geometry is more pure. I can use division by spacing it, by dividing using a distance or length. So that can help me get a much better, clearer geometry, because currently it is a little bit abrupt, but I'll stick to it for this tutorial. So this is that sweep which I am getting out this curve, and then I can also play with it a little bit for making it into a mesh. I can use this for making it into a mesh. Now I can make it into a mesh. Then I can smoothen this mesh using the Weaver Bird tool, CAD tool, CLAB tool. This has smoothened the curve a little bit. It is looking more. It is looking finer. And now this is the mesh which I would like to create for this tutorial. See how sine curve has made this beautiful geometry. I can even change the parameters to explore different options. For example, in this case, I want a more closer kind of network between the curves. So see how this has changed the geometry which I was exploring so for this project. So I can also play with different angles and stuff, which is, I think this was looking much better. So I can again go here, over here, and adjust this part as per my preference. So this will also make an interesting form. I think earlier one was much better. So this is the kind of geometry which I was trying to explore, the wavy geometry. This is looking really, very interesting. And this is in a simple mesh form currently. Now what I can do is make a kind of pattern over it for getting an interesting roof kind of structure if I want. This can be mounds or anything. Now I would like to see the edges of this mesh. So currently, due to Catmull Clark subdivision, it has smoothened it a lot, but the original mesh was something like this. So I like the smoothened texture of this mesh, but I think I like it better in this form. So this is looking really good. Now I have different options which I can play with. For example, I can just do the picture frame in which I'll just choose this mesh, and as per the framing it will just make a frame out of it. Now if I'll hide it, it has just made it into an interesting frame of meshes. And then I can also thicken this edge by going it into mesh thicken. So choosing this and provide by default it will normally extrude it, so it will thicken itself and give it a little bit of weight to the model to showcase how it will look. So I just bake this product to get the output. See, this is the mesh which I have created. I baked it way too many times, but this was the geometry which I was trying to achieve, and this can be further explored. Like, this is looking really interesting. I think it will look better if I just add a plane to this. Just for the visual purpose, I can reduce the scale So this is a kind of view which has been created by this curve, and it is looking really very interesting. Now I can further play with it by placing some human figures or things, but this curve is really very interesting, as you can see, giving a surreal feel, and we can really explore a little bit more into it. So yeah, I'll just add few human figures in this. This is the final output out of that curve which I tried to generate, and it is looking nice. This is looking interesting. So I'll just take out this view and make this my thumbnail. So I think I got my thumbnail for the video as well. So I hope you guys got to learn about how to use mathematical geometries and create something which is very interesting and very creative. So if you guys like my video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so that you get notified about every new video which I upload, and comment on this video, suggest, comment, do whatever you like in that section. It is open and free, and do like my video. I really appreciate that, and hope to see you guys soon in the next video. Take care, guys.